And now, the six married murderesses of the Cook County Jail in their rendition of the Cell Block Tango. Chew gum. No, not chew. Pop. So I came home this one day and I'm really irritated and I'm looking for a little bit of sympathy. And there's Bernie, lying on the couch, drinking a beer and chewing. No, not chewing. Popping. So I said to him, I said, "You pop that gum one more time." And he did. So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired two warning shots. Into his head.
He had it coming. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have been there, if you'd have heard it, I bet you would have done the same.
I met Ezekiel Young from Salt Lake City about 2 years ago. And he told me he was single, and we hit it off right away. So we started living together. He'd go to work, he'd come home, I'd fix him a drink, and we'd have dinner. And then I found out, single, he told me. Single my butt. Not only was he married, who knows, he had six wives. One of those Mormons, you know? So that night, when he came home from work, I fixed him his drink, as usual. You know, some guys just can't hold their arsenic.
He had it coming. He had it coming. He took a flower in its prime. And then he used it. And he abused it. It was a murder, but not a crime.
Now I'm standing in the kitchen, carving up the chicken for dinner, minding my own business. In storms my husband Wilburn in a jealous rage. He was crazy, and he kept on screaming. And then he ran into my knife. He ran into my knife 10 times.
He had it coming. He had it coming. Six. He took a flower in its prime. And then he used it. And he abused it. Six. It was a murder, but not a crime.
Scissor on the
chest.
Me. Κύριε Σικέ, ο Σμονιάκος αίρος λόγουμ λέβε από το κομφιέρκ. Είμαι γλέσσο από το μοφιέρκ. Δεν είμαι γος. Εν άρρωτ λόμβοιόκ. Να απτερόμ. Μερ μοιάνκος αμχουκ ίνταν σαμ. Ρόμπολτόμ. Παρέντες έγγιλ μεγ μωράζνι. Την αμερτάτικ μεγ.
Yeah, but did you do it?
Not guilty. My sister Veronica and I had this double act, and my husband Charlie traveled along with us. Now, for the last number in our act, we had these 20 acrobatic tricks in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, splits, spread eagles, backflips, flip-flops, one right after the other. Now, this one night before the show, we're down at the Hotel Cicero. The three of us, boozing, having a few laughs, and we ran out of ice. So I go out to get some. I come back, open the door. And there's Veronica and Charlie doing number 17, the spread eagle. Well, I was in such a state of shock, I completely blacked out. I can't remember a thing. It wasn't until later, when I was washing the blood off my hands, I even knew they were dead.
They had it coming.
They had it coming.
They had it coming.
They had it coming.
All along.
dipshits more than I could possibly say. He was a real artistic guy. Sensitive. A painter. But he was always trying to find himself. He'd go out every night looking for himself, and on the way, he found Ruth, Gladys, Rosemary, and Irving. I guess you could say we broke up because of artistic differences. He saw himself as alive, and I saw him dead.
He had it coming, he had it coming, he had it coming, he had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it,
single my ass.
Hand time.
Merno Yanko Sam Hukin Dan Sam.
Number 17.
Spread it.
Artistic difference. 6.
Squish. Scissor roll.